It's the first week on the job for the newly appointed acting socioeconomic secretary of the Philippines after his predecessor surprisingly stepped down. After his four-year stint in the finance department, acting secretary Carl Chua will now be leading efforts on the economic recovery of the country when the storm has passed over the COVID-19 pandemic. Once the poster boy of the Duterte administration's tax reform program, Chua's independence as the new leader of the country's flagship economic planning agency has been questioned by some industry observers and even his predecessor. But Chua dismisses these, asserting his track record as an objective economist should speak for itself.
I have not changed my position since I was in UP on tax reform when I was research assistant to the fiscal crisis paper of the UP 11. I have not changed in the World Bank, in DOF, and not also in NEDA. The reason is I have studied and I understand this objectively.
As concurrent Director General of the National Economic and Development Authority, Chua shared his marching orders from the President, formulating an economic recovery plan from the health crisis, expediting the national ID system implementation, and supporting the Build, Build, Build program. They plan to make the multi-billion dollar infrastructure program as the main catalyst for the country's eventual recovery. Chua adds final details of any plan can only be revealed once they have a clear view of COVID-19's economic impact.
We are working right now on a quantitative survey so that we can also ask the large corporations apart from the MSME. Once we have an idea of how much is the damage, the loss, the impact, then we will be able to propose a better crafted stimulus or fiscal or recovery or bounce back plan.
But contrary to what former NEDA Chief Ernesto Pernia has been pushing for weeks before his resignation, Chua is sticking to caution over calls to restart businesses.
Our thinking here is that we have to understand fully the trade-off of the decision that we will have to make, because when we allow millions of people to go out and take the public transport, they will be the means to carry the virus. And other countries have already seen a second surge of the virus. So we have to be very careful.
This is the same view of his former boss at the finance department, Secretary Carlos Dominguez III, on mounting proposals for a gradual reopening of businesses in the country amid the possible extension of the Luzon lockdown. NEDA chairs the country's Interagency Task Force Technical Working Group for Anticipatory and Forward Planning, which is tasked to push for policies on how people and the economy should function once the health emergency is addressed. So from tax reform, Chua is now seen to become the poster boy of the new normal following the COVID-19 pandemic. Bruce Rodriguez, ABS-CBN News.